You're tuned into BoomBox Deluxe's channel, and this is another test time video. Hello then, people. What we got up in front of the camera then is my old tester. Okay. Now, that tester up in front of the camera there, I've had that since I was about 7 or 8 years old, and I've decided basically it's time to put it into retirement. Okay. Yeah, I've had that since I was about 7 or 8 years old. Okay. Typical 1980s bit of kit that. Yeah, I've had, like I say, had that for many, many years. You know, I've done all sorts of interesting measurements with it, given that how basic it is. Yeah, it's got me out of all sorts of scrapes and situations and goodness knows what else. You know, I've had something where I think, well, why is that not working? Straight out with a tester, get the test probes in there, bit of continuity. Oh, look, there's no continuity on the live conductor or something like that. Brilliant bit of kit, okay. Now, still fully functional, okay. After all these years, you know, I've had it here, there, and all over the place. It's been knocked, it's been kicked, it's been dropped, things put on it, it's been shoved in a bucket upside down with loads of other tools. You know, it's taken a lot of beating, right? But here's the thing. I did say it's still fully functional, and that's the reason why, after all these years, I'm putting it into retirement. Quite simply because I want to do that before something really unfortunate happens to it. Okay? You know, it's been a very good tester, I will say that. Yeah? Let's turn it around and you can have a look at it. Pop. There it is then. Okay. Let's turn that down. There you go. Let's take the probes out of it. Let's move the probes out of the way. There you go. Okay. So there it is. My little tester that I've had since about 7 or 8 years old. And very, very basic. Okay. It hasn't got a dial on it or nothing. You just basically choose your setting by means of putting the black probe where it says common probe, okay, up the left hand there. So you get your black probe. Again, look at the state of that. That one's actually not too bad. It's got a bit of a bend in it, okay, but you put your black one in there like that, okay. And then, let's say for example we want to measure volts on a battery. You take your red test probe. Again, look how distorted and twisted that is. Okay. It's in better days. Supposing we wanted to test for DC battery then, you manually select your function. There's no switch or dial or nothing like that. That's probably why it's lasted that long. You know, there's no rotary parts to wear out. It's just you take your test probe and stuff it in there like that. And, hang on a minute, people. I've got claws up my backside. Toby, did you have to do that? He's just reached up in the seat, the funny animal, and he's clawed my backside. That wasn't nice. I'm going to have you for that in a minute. Right. Where were we before I was so rudely interrupted by claws stuck in my backside and the Tobias? He should know by now, claw control. He can sit there by the back door and wait. He knows he's done wrong and I'm going to have him for that in a minute. Tester up in front of the camera then. Okay. Put your test probes in. There's a couple of functions around the side there, little function switches. There it is. Okay. Am I getting on that? There it is. DC and AC. Okay, so you put it on the direct current function. I'll show you what that switch is for in a minute. Okay, and then you get your battery. It goes, I think the maximum on that's 15 volts. Okay, on that bottom range. Okay, it says DC battery there. Making sure you get the polarity the right way round. Put it on the battery and it will go up. Okay, I've tested loads and loads of batteries with this. Okay, say for example a little 9 volt DC battery. You can put it on there, and if it say only comes up to about there, you know that the battery is worn out because it's supposed to go there where it says 9 volts. Okay, so if your needle will only come up about halfway, you know your battery's had it. Okay, really advantageous piece of kit that. Yeah, and if you wanted to test for AC power, again it doesn't say on the scale, but up the top there, what the voltage is. Okay, it's either safe or live. So basically it's like a thing for saying whether or not a socket's live or not. Okay. I wouldn't want to plug this into a proving unit, okay, because I think the maximum voltage on this is like 240 volts. And some of these proving units go up to 690 volts. Okay, so if you could imagine basically something like this and stuffing it into a proving unit at 690 volts, it'll pop it. Okay, and another thing you can't do with this, like I've already said, is measure what the voltage is. Okay, so I can get those test probes there, put those in the wall socket, and it goes from the green to the red, which says it's either safe or dead, or live and energized. Okay, that's all it does, it just does that. Okay, and when you put it on that, down the bottom there, on AC power with your test probes, you then got to go around the side here and flick it over to AC. It's all a bit manual. Okay, and then you get your test probes, put them in what you want to test whether it's live or not. And if it is, then that goes right the way up. And it says, yes, it's live. Okay, but like I say, when you do these things with live mains electricity, you've got to test the tester. Okay, so let's say, for example, I'll set all that up and whatnot. I'll get the test probes, and then that drops out, okay? Puts that in the thing. Oh, look, it's not moving. Okay, it's got to be dead, hasn't it? And then you put your hand in, and you get blasted, and then it's only later on you found out that your test probe dropped out. Okay? You've got to be very careful around mains electricity. The last thing that this can do, and I will do it up in front of the camera now, take that out of there, and put it in there. That is where it stays most of the time. Okay, in the continuity test function, circuit test. Okay, when it's in that one, round the side there, change it over to AC, and that one there, it says battery, off and on, put it to on. Okay. There's your little display there. You can see the needle, and get your test probes, touch them together, and there you go, the needle's going up. Okay, and there we go, that's your continuity test. Tuck the needles together like that, your test probes, and up it goes. Okay, very very handy bit of kit for that, testing fuses, extension leads that are unplugged of course, all that sort of business. One thing that I would have really liked this to have, which it doesn't do, and it is basically, when you're doing continuity test, when you get a circuit for this thing to bleep, or look a little buzzer in there or something like that, that doesn't do it, okay? So, you know, that could be sort of all the way over there, like that, okay? I'm here, and I'm like, say, testing whether or not the windings have burnt out on a motor or something. You put that in there and you've got to basically strain your head to look over there to see whether or not the needle's going up. Okay. Another thing that doesn't do is if you've only got part of a circuit, it doesn't say what resistance it is. Okay. It's either that needle goes up or it doesn't. And I have had situations before now where I've tested something and I've got part circuit. And what happens is that needle only goes up like halfway. Okay. Another little fun thing that I used to do with this when I was younger is basically stick those test probes on your tongue and that you can get it to go up. I'm going to do that now because it would be rude not to. Okay, I'm going to stick those on my tongue. It's on the circuit test, which is 9 volts maximum. There you go, my tongue's got continuity to it. Okay, so there we go. Yeah, I'll honestly put that on my tongue. Another thing you can do is wet your hand, hold on to that one, then hold on to that one like that, and get that to go up. There you go, you can see that I was doing that then. I haven't wetted my hands, they're dry. But look at this. I can get that zoom to behave. If I get hold of that one like that, and get hold of that one like that, you can get that needle to go up. There you go. See, it's only going up a bit because I've got a relatively high resistance. But it's detecting it. There you go. If I pinch them really hard, there you go. So I've got hold of them like that, and that needle's going up. So I've got relatively high resistance, but it's detecting it and showing it on that moving needle there. Okay, and that can sometimes happen if you've got a bit of a bad circuit and it doesn't quite go full deflection. Okay, again, what it does not do is show you, say for example, when it's only halfway up, what the resistance is. It could be, for example, so many ohms, but it doesn't do that. Okay, it's very, very basic. It's either you've got a circuit or you haven't, or as with my fingers, it's somewhere in between, but it doesn't say what that in between is. Okay, very, very basic. So there are things on that which I wish it did do, but it doesn't. Okay, the Tobias is sat by the kitchen door. He's waiting. He knows he's going to get told off in a minute. That tester up in front of the camera, then, I've got a feeling, don't quote me on this, but when that was on sale in the shop, I do believe that there was another version of that, another make and model, and it was slightly more advanced. It had other bells and whistles on it and things, and it could do other features and functions and goodness knows what else. And chances are that one did have a buzzer in it and done other things, like, say, for example, a diode test. Okay, you could use that to do diode test if you know how to do a diode test. Okay, basically you put your test probes on there in one position, you get nothing, and then if you flip the test probes around and put them on there, that should go up. Okay, because you do get a test voltage across there of about 9 volts. Okay, so you might be able to do a diode test with that, I don't know, I've never done a diode test. But it might do it might not, I don't know. But I'm pretty sure, to say, don't quote me on this though, but when that was on sale in the shop, there was another version of that, slightly more advanced, that had extra bells and whistles on it. Okay. You've seen it there up in front of the camera. And what I want to do, like I said, while it's still fully functional, before something really unfortunate happens to it, I want to put that into retirement, basically. It's been a fantastic little tester. I couldn't, chuck it out or pop it or nothing like that. I'm not going to do anything nasty with it. You know, it's got me out of all sorts of dings and scrapes and situations over the years. You know, look, why is the fuse not working or why is an extension lead not working? Straight out with a continuity tester, and I think, yeah, that's why. It's either the fuse is blown or the live conductor and extension lead has failed or it's come loose or something like that. And it's got me out of the situation in which I found myself. Okay, so I'm going to put that into retirement before something unfortunate happens to it, like I accidentally stand on it. I've nearly done that a few times, or something heavy gets dropped on it. It's almost happened. Something heavy has almost landed on it, and because of that, I want to put that into retirement before something really unfortunate happens to it. Because I'm pretty sure there will be tears if that does, because, you know. Being that tester, you know, we've been together we've been together a very long time. So it's time for a rapid test up there, up in front of the camera there, to go into retirement while it's still fully functional. What I'm going to do is I'm going to slip in a commercial break now. When we come back, you can see the piece of test equipment which is going to replace that. Okay, where are we? 15 and 20 then. So we'll go for 15 minutes and 30 seconds and then we'll go for a commercial break. Okay, don't move a muscle, it's straight after this. Here we are then, back after the commercial break. And during the commercial break, Toby got a telling off for giving me claws. Okay, so I had him on the floor and his ears were folded back. He knew what was coming. Okay, so he got a telling off. Okay, as we know in other videos, he has ways of asking if he wants to go out. Okay, and sticking claws up my backside is not it. Okay, he can mew on. He can come and rub my leg. He can sit there in front of me and stare into my eyes. But one thing he does not do, because it's not nice and I'm not having it, is to basically creep up behind me and stick claws up my backside. Okay, I'm not having it. It's not nice. It's just once every so often he misbehaves. You know, he sort of tries to overstep the mark a bit. That tester up in front of the camera then, we've had a good old look at it in section one. Okay. I've wrapped all the test leads around it because that's how I usually do it and that's how I've done it all these years. Okay, finished using it, switch it off around the side there, wrap all the test leads around it and it gets chucked back in the, quite literally, chucked back in the toolbox or in the bucket with loads of other tools in there. Yeah, I really think, really, speaking, that tester up in front of the camera, that should be knighted, given what it's had to put up with over the years. It's done well, but I've got a new tester, people. Now, I will promise you this, this is entirely coincidental. There it is, okay, replacement tester. And, well, have yourself a look at this. It's another rapid test. Okay. Yeah, like I say, it's entirely coincidental that. I was looking around on that there popular auction website one evening and well that was up for grabs. £15, brand new, still in the packet. Okay. Yes, it's brand new, still in the packet, rapid test. It's a clamp meter as well. Okay, so it's got extra features and functions on it, which my other one didn't have. Yeah, you know, so £15, I thought to myself, I'm going to have that. Like I say, it does extra features and functions on it. We'll have it out the case in a minute. But yeah, it is a rapid test tester there. Okay, brand new, still in the packet, unused, and there it is. Okay, it's a clamp meter, it's got extra features and functions on it, so obviously speaking, you can do continuity with it, you can test voltage, AC and DC, and the thing is, unlike my other one, which only went up to 15 volts, you can get this one up to 600 volts on AC and DC. Okay, and you can obviously measure amperage with it on the clamp. Okay, the ranges on it is 2 amp, 20 amp and 200 amp. Now you can't see it really because of this casing that it's in. So I've got a pair of scissors and we'll cut this case open. We'll have that out of there. It says that down the bottom, if you can see it, the operating instructions inside. So we'll open this up very carefully with a pair of scissors and get that tester out of there and have a look at it. Like I say, it is in the packet, so I don't know whether there's a battery in it or not. Okay. Hold on for the disappointment. Okay, we might turn this on and find, oh dear, there's no battery in it. I don't know. I'm cutting with the scissors. £15 on that popular auction website. Right, that's really tough plastic. Yeah, I kind of figured that before something unfortunate happens with that other tester, like other rapid tester continuity device, I would put that into retirement because, you know, me and that tester, we've been together a long time, and well, it'd be really unfortunate if something bad happens to it. So while it's still fully functional, let's get another one. Okay, that other tester, that can go in the Boombox Deluxe History Museum. Okay, there it is then. Little clamp meter. Let's turn it round and... To get the battery out, you've got to take a little screw out. What I'm going to do, to save me faffing around with screws, I'm just going to turn it on anyway. The on and off on this is actually a press button. Okay, on some other clamp meters, you just turn that to the first position and it all lights up. Okay, so I don't know whether there's a battery in it or not. Prepare for the disappointment. Here we go. There's no battery in it, people. Turn it on another range. On or off? Maybe we've got to hold the button. No, I've got to put a battery in it. No. What battery does it go in there? DC3VX3. So I've got a feeling that is three double A's that have got to go in the back of that. Okay. So there we go. Let's open the clamp up. There we go. It's a clamp. Okay. Again, that'll be handy when I'm doing phantom loading on electric meters. Okay, we've got a 20 amp range on that. So if I'm doing phantom loading with the metering board, that range will be perfect. Okay, so if I accidentally crank the variac up a bit too much and push the metering board beyond its limits, this thing will start bleeping or say OL on there or whatever it does. And I think to myself, oh yeah, I'm overdoing the metering board a bit too much. Turn the variac down. Okay, so let's turn that down to there. So I've got to get some batteries to go in it. Okay. In a way, it's not such a bad thing there isn't batteries in it, because when this was made, between that being made and me buying it, that could have been on the shelf for like nine or 10 months. And those batteries in the back could have leaked and made a glorious pig's ear in there. So really speaking, it's not so much of a bad thing that there isn't any batteries in it anyway. But we've yet to look inside that case. Now this could be interesting. I've opened that up carefully on camera. I don't know what's in the case, so there's no cheating in here going on. In that case, it does actually say down the bottom there, operating instructions inside. Who's to say that there's also not a little packet of batteries in there? Let's open it up. Rightio then. Test leads. Now this has got those little tips on it. Okay. Do they detach? Yes, they do. Look at that. So you get little detachable tips. Oh, actually, no. That's little covers, so you don't accidentally stab yourself on them. Right. So, yeah, I thought that was just like a little thing so that it complies with GS38 or something like that. But no, they're actually little covers. So you don't, you can't stab yourself with them. Okay, I don't know if there's anyone out there that's ever done that. You've reached in the toolbox or whatnot, and you've got one of those tips stuck up the back of your fingernail. That can properly flipping hurt, I'm telling you. So, yeah. You've got the little protective tips on there so you don't stab yourself on them. And if I take it off and do that. Oh, yes, they're very, very pointed, in fact. You can see a little mark it's leaving behind when I do that. Yes, that is why you've got them little tips on there, so you don't stab yourself with them, okay? There's your little shrouded things on there. Again, that's an improvement to the old ones, because with the old ones, that thing in there was exposed, okay? Little set of test leads then. Pretty basic, but then for £15, you know, they don't need to be super fantango, do they? Here comes that case then. Is there any batteries in there? Let's unzip it. It feels quite light, as if there's not any in there. Let's unzip it. And... well, what do you know? Batteries. That's interesting. It's got, you've got to put three whopping great of those devices in it. Okay. Where's my instruction book then? No instruction book in there. That's interesting. Maybe it's in there. Is it in here? There it is. The instruction manual. Okay. So there it was. It's hiding in between there. So you would have think they'd put it inside there. Because after undoing that, you could have chucked that straight in the bin. So there's our instruction manual. Okay. Precaution and safety measures. Okay. Don't chuck it in a bucket of water. Things like that. Do not use it to measure the output of a microwave oven transformer. Things like that. Yeah, it's all in there. Okay. Oh, it says here, to avoid electrical shock or damage to the meter, do not get water inside the case. Ah, so it's not waterproof then. Tell me something that I don't know. Right, there you go. That's shows you what's on the display then. Okay. All the various different things that it can show. There we go. There it is. Right then. Where are we up to? 11 minutes on this section. What I want to do, seeing as that we couldn't get it working, because there's no batteries already in it. We'll go for another commercial break when we come back. We shall get those batteries and put them in the tester, I think. We'll turn it on, see if we can get it lit up. And yeah, the only thing I'm hoping about this is these batteries that are widely available. Okay. Yeah, hopefully these replacement batteries are widely available, because I'd really hate it if I've just bought that, I've paid £15 for it and you can't get them batteries anywhere, and once the batteries have run out, that's the end of that tester. Okay, so there you go. So I'm going to leave those there. We'll slip in a little commercial break then. When we come back, we'll have those batteries in that tester. I could do that on camera after the commercial break. We'll have those batteries in the tester after the commercial break then. And we'll get that turned on and showing some numbers and things. Here we are then, back after the commercial break. And that tester up in front of the camera there has got its three little batteries set there on the worktop. Okay. Now those batteries, they are lithium. Okay. So hopefully they will last a reasonable amount of time inside that clamp meter. Okay. Yeah. One thing I have just thought about actually about that tester, when I tried turning it on, is basically with my old tester, it could actually test its own battery. Okay. And the way you do that is you get the battery out of the tester. Okay. Put it onto the DC battery function, put the test probes on the 9 volt battery, and it would actually, the needle would go up and say how many volts are left in the battery. Okay, with this one, you probably can't do that, because to get that display to light up, you've got to actually have batteries in it. Okay, so already we're at a slight disadvantage there. So it's probably not so much of a bad thing that I have retired that other tester before it broke or something unfortunate happened to it. Given the size of the battery cover on the back of it, it does make me wonder, why have they not put a 9 volt smoke alarm, one of the type of batteries you get in a smoke alarm. Why is there not one of those in there? When I remove the cover, have yourself a look at this. Okay, I've already taken the back the cover screw out. It's really, really difficult to get the cover detached. There we go. Ready? Pop. Okay, all that space, you could have fitted a 9-volt battery in there, but all you've got is a round hole. Okay. I'd seem to think you've got to stack the batteries on top of each other. Those contacts in there being, I don't know whether that's positive or negative. That would be the negative in the middle. Okay, we've got a dirty great fingerprint on that, which is probably not so much of a good thing. Okay. Right, let's just rub that better. Okay then, so in it goes. You've got to drop them in there, one at a time. There we go, one. Two. And then three. I'd seem to think something like that. There we go. And then, and just then put the cover on. I'd seem to think it's something like that. We'll soon find out. Let's put the screw in. Silliest little screw. You wouldn't want to lose that on a building site, would you? Silliest little screw going in. Tighten up a screwdriver. Again, you don't get a screwdriver with it. So if you're out in the middle of nowhere and the battery's run out and you haven't got a screwdriver, oh dearie me. Let's see if it lights up then. Yay! Oh, right. This is one of these. That's one of them buttons where, basically speaking, you push it and it goes in and stays in. And then, to turn it off, you press it and the button pops back out again. A bit like what you'd get on the front of a hi-fi system or whatever. Right, it just says that on it. Okay. I seem to think that basically means it's open circuit because it's on the continuity range. Okay. I am going to, because I want to know whether or not this has got a bleeper in it, bearing in mind I've not looked in the instruction manual. I'm going to get our test probes. I am going to put them in. It's pretty obvious what happens where. We put the red one in the red hole and the black one in the black hole. We don't need the instruction manual for that. Okay then. Let's see if this thing has got a bleeper in it. If it has, that'll be a nice little bonus. Let's take our tips off. Like so. Again, you always do this with a continuity tester before testing your fuses or an extension lead or something, just to make sure your tester's working. It's got a bleeper in it. It's a bit of a funny squealy bleeper, but it's got a bleeper. I don't know if you'll listen, I don't know if you'll hear this, but here we go. There we go. It's not quite zeroing. Oh dear, we haven't got a zero function on this. So there we go, we've got 1 ohm on our test leads. So we'd have to remember to take that off before doing any tests. So there we go, it's got a bleeper in it, which is very handy. Let's test the continuity of these scissors. Okay. Let's see if we've got continuity on the scissors. Well, that's interesting. No, we haven't. Well, that is bizarre. You would seem to think those scissors are conductive, but apparently not. What about my blade then? That's got to be conductive, isn't it? Rightio, it's not doing anything anymore now. I wonder why that is. Let's turn it off and turn it back on again. Rightio. Okay, I'm touching the test lead together, but it's not doing anything now. do wonder if the lead test leads are faulty or something. Yeah, that's a bit. Yeah, it's a bit loose. That. Yeah, it's that negative one. It's very loose. That's a bit disappointing. Then straight off. Yeah, it's a bit loose, that negative one. Yeah, look, it's a bit wobbly, that. That live one's nice and tight, though. What I might have to do, or shouldn't have to do it, mind you, and that is, you've got, like, two, it's like, splits in there, cross splits. And that's basically stuff a screwdriver in there, a small screwdriver, and spread them out a bit wider. Like, so you shouldn't have to do this after getting it out of the box. Again, this is what I'm saying about when you're doing continuity tests. You test the tester first, make sure you've got continuity there, because I could have tested the fuse then, think to myself, oh, that fuse has failed, when in fact it's actually the tester. So I've widened that out a bit in there now. You shouldn't have to do that, but there we go. Let's plug it back in. Much better. I'm going to do the live one as well, the positive one. That is so much better. Let's get the other one in there. Screwdriver in the other one. Shouldn't have to do this after getting it brand new out the flipping box. Right. That's much better. That's what I want. So, slight hiccup there, turn it on. Now that I've got a tighter connection on there, I'm wondering if that was zero. Again, loose connections, you'll get resistance reading. Oh, there we go. We've lost that 1 ohm that I was saying about earlier. So there you go, you see. That loose connection on there, we had 1 ohm of resistance. Now that I've sorted it out, we got zero. I'll apologise if you've got headphones on for that. But as you can see, I've made that a bit of a firmer connection. And we've now got zero on our reading. Okay. So there you go. It tested itself and said that there was a fault. Now, I said earlier on, let's see if we can test the conductivity of these scissors. Okay. See if it works this time. It should do. They're metallic. There we go. Okay, then we've got 1 ohm. Oh, no. Well, there you go. Them scissors have got 0 ohms to them. But we've got a bleeper in that, which is very, very handy. Okay. Let's do the light function. I'm going to take the test probes out. That is so much better now. Light function, then. It'll do it. There you go. Oh, look, it's green. It's glowing. Can I get the light to turn off? I don't know why, but it got battery light come on that. Oh, has it gone off? Yeah. Maybe it just... Yeah, it fades out. Okay, so turn it on like that. It stays on for a little while and then fades out. Okay, there you go. You can't actually turn it back off. You just press it, it comes on, stays on for a few seconds, and then fades out. Okay, so I've learnt something there. Again, I should really go look at the instruction manual. Volts DC. It says volts DC down there. And there you go, 0 volts. Toby's returned. There he is. Tobias! I think he wants to come in. But we're doing a video. I'm doing a video, Tobias. You'll have to wait. So, that's volts DC then. It's on 0. Fantastic. Volts AC. Again, we've got the little AC logo up there. There we go. 0 volts. You'll have to wait. He's mewing on ever so well out there. Right then, amperage range, 2-amp range, okay? That's interesting. It says zero, I'm pretty sure I saw a decimal point then. So we've got 0 amps there. Now it's got a decimal point down there. I'm wondering if this can get down to something like 1 milliamp. We're going to have to try this out a little bit later on. We'll get some phantom amps going through that and see what we can get. 20 amp then? Yeah, look, decimal point's moved over. So I'm wondering whether or not this can get down to something like 1 or 2 milliamps. If so, that'll be very handy. And a 200 amp range. And the decimal point moves over one more. Okay. And it says it down the bottom there, 200. So there we go. There you go, it's zeroed. Again, this doesn't have a zero on it, so it's a good thing that it zeroes anyway. Okay. Right, let's turn it off then. There we go. Right, so I'm going to put that back onto down the bottom there. Okay then, so rapid test clamp meter then. Okay. Toby, you'll have to wait. Look at this. He's out there mewing on ever so well. There he is. You going to mew then? There he goes. He's done his little mew. He wants to come in, people. So, here's a Tobias. Rapid test clamp meter then. I didn't say the model number, did I? MS 2002. Okay. So there we go. Not a bad little instrument that, but what I will say, as a slight disappointment, those, I've had to get in there with a screwdriver and widen those out so that it grips that inside there. You shouldn't have to do that after getting it straight out of the packet. I mean, your average person probably would have found, oh, that's faulty, I'll send it back. Okay, and they would have had to go with all the inconvenience and rigmarole of doing that. I've put the little test probes back on, the little protective tips, so you don't stab yourself on it. So overall, I'm pretty impressed with that. Okay, for £15, but I would have preferred, really speaking, for that to have an everyday, widely available 9-volt smoke alarm battery in that instead of those circular ones. I'm going to have to keep hold of that and see if I can get any replacement batteries anywhere. I should put that in the little pouch there. Okay. So, where are we then? Getting on for 15 minutes. Rapid test tester. We should get some phantom amps on that a bit later on the Variac, and we'll see what we get for some readings. Okay, I've got to go. Toby wants to come in. Stay tuned for more action on that, and for 15 minutes on this one, people. Thanks for watching.